Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome back to another episode of the Venom Vlog. And today I wanted to try to do a little bit of digging. You know, this is Saturday right now, February 1st, and I just got off a live stream a little bit ago with some of you guys, and I wanted to record some episodes before I go in for my surgery. And one thing I saw in the live stream was a lot of people seem to be upset, or at least a couple people seem to be upset, and I see this online too, of why we're not getting any movie news. We're not seeing behind the scenes photos or videos or anything like that. And like I said, and I've explained numerous times, and I still get people asking me, even though I'm like, I explained it in my video, just watch the video. I know, you know, everyone's busy and they got, you know, they got other things they got going on, their other shows they watch and stuff, but I do cover a lot of this stuff in my videos and talk about them. And so one of the things I covered was they're shooting a lot on closed sets in London right now for Venom 2. So it's hard to get any kind of sneak peek at stuff. And some of the photographers and people they might let in aren't allowed to share those photos until certain dates because they have to time it with, you know, PR stuff and with marketing stuff. So there's just no info right now. And so people seem to be upset by that. And it's like, hey, just give it time. All right. They're, you know, they can't, I already explained, they can't shoot too much outside in London because London's very specifically looks like London. So unless you do like really close-up shots or, you know, pick an alley that can kind of be anything, you can't really shoot too much outside and make it look like San Francisco. They're going to have to do a lot of that stuff in San Francisco. And so as you guys know from the first Venom movie, there was a lot of stuff we didn't see for like 2 months of nothing, you know, because they shot on close sets in Atlanta. And then they started shooting out in the streets of Atlanta right before they went to San Francisco. And we saw some of that stuff. And that kind of got leaked out there, you know, through people living in Atlanta taking photos and videos of it. And then they went to San Francisco and same thing. So we just got to wait. You know, once they go to a place where they can shoot more outside, yes, we will get more outside in exterior shots. So for sure. But I still, you know, I know a lot of you guys are just jonesing for some kind of information. So I was like, well, you know, and you also mentioned, some of you mentioned the IMDb page and how they updated it with some new actors and stuff. So I said, you know, that's not 100%, you know, fully credible as a source for, you know, sometimes. But as I explained in season one of the show, the reason why I do go to IMDb is for smaller roles, typically. So people who are like trying to get into the industry, or they're up and coming actors, or they're like, you know, smaller actors who are getting their big break in this movie or whatever, or they're, you know, their Instagram, you know, people or, you know, whatever it is, that, you know, usually those roles, they'll announce them ASAP on IMDb. Because the agents or the people that represent, you know, these other actors, these smaller actors that are in these movies, and I'm not saying that to belittle them, obviously, they're just playing smaller roles. When I say smaller actors, it's they're playing smaller parts or bit parts or day playing or whatever, but they play these characters in the movie that don't have a ton of screen time, but they do get a little bit of screen time, obviously, and so their representation will want to put them in the IMDb page, because obviously they're only going to go and film for like a day or two, or sometimes maybe a week if they're lucky, and then that information needs to get on IMDb because they're going to need that to get their next job. And so they can say, hey, he just shot Venom 2 in like a week and now he's looking for more work. You know, what do you got? Or she was just on the set for a day and she needs this, you know, and she did this on the movie and she needs work, you know, for her next, she's trying to line up her next project. And she was in Venom 2 and Venom 1 was a big hit. So, you know, they use that to, you know, their people use that to market them and get them new jobs and stuff like that. So typically smaller roles, like I said, I will pay attention to on IMDb. And some of you guys mentioned that to me like less than a month ago. And I was like, yeah, I'll keep an eye on it, keep an eye on it. And I felt like now's a good time because there are some roles here that, you know, kind of expand some potential story elements. And I figured we could dive into them. So this is going to be two videos. The first video we're going to talk about here is going to be for the San Francisco Police Department. I noticed that this one has more people, more cast members that are playing SFPD officers. And although there was like a couple in the first movie who got credited as, you know, San Francisco police or whatever, this movie seems to be, you know, have a couple already. We have Sean Delaney, who is a young actor who was in Killing Eve, the TV show, and he's like a recurring character on there, and he's like a hacker on that show. So I was like, all right, I had to do some research. I'm like, what's his character? Okay, he's a hacker, because on his Instagram page he posted this picture right here, and this picture has him in a police uniform that says on the patch when you zoom in, San Francisco Police Department. So I'm gonna assume, and this was during the time they're filming Venom, and so I'm going to assume that he is going to be playing a San Francisco police officer. Whether it's a main character or not, we don't know. All these guys, you know, we saw some characters in the first movie. We were like, oh, this guy and this girl have been in these movies. So they might have like a speaking role or something. And they didn't. They just had like, they popped up for a scene or two here and there. So we don't know the extent of his role. But seeing him in this costume and seeing him, you know, having that picture, great black and white picture, by the way, It made me start thinking, all right, let's see who else is in this movie. Let's see who else is playing San Francisco police officers. So we have Sean Delaney there. Looks like, and I'm not confirming this, but it seems very likely, and because this is just me, there's no source here other than I went to Sean Delaney's Instagram and I saw this photo and I was like, oh, that, and it's during the filming days of Venom 2. So I'm like, all right, I'm just going to connect this dot. And could I be wrong? Sure. But I feel like I could be right in this one. So so again, no confirmation, nothing's confirmed, but it's more likely that he might be actually in Venom 2 as a SFPD officer. So then we also have Alfredo Tavares, and he's posted and listed as a San Francisco police officer uniformed. That's what they titled him in the credits on IMDb. So it looks like he might be playing a San Francisco police officer also, according to the credit. And when I went to his page, though, I couldn't find anything. I saw a couple shots of him just enjoying London itself, and so I was like, all right, so that shows that he was in London, and you know, so that could connect him to this movie. But he does also seem like he shoots a lot of stuff in the UK and in other countries surrounding it and stuff. So you know, nothing's confirmed here either, but seeing him on the list and everything, I was like, all right, that's cool. That you know, lends to more stuff that I can put in this video, which I wanted to focus on the SFPD, because if we're seeing an increase in San Francisco Police Department officers, maybe that means they're going to play a bigger role in the movie. So again, speculation here, but I'm trying to just connect dots that seem logical, and by basing on the actors that, you know, and who's and what roles they're playing and stuff. So we also have a third person listed named Obi Matthew, and he's listed as a San Francisco police officer or police detective, San Francisco police detective, and but he's uncredited apparently. So again, that could just be his representation, or you know, or him himself, or someone putting his name on there saying like, hey, he wasn't credited in the movie, but he's in the background. He plays, you know, a detective, and he has his own desk, or he's sitting behind, you know, another character or whatever. And so when I started seeing all this, it made me think about, you know, that leaked image that people posted, which I wasn't sure actually came from Tom Hardy or not. And I'm still not sure. I mean, maybe you guys, one of you can definitively tell me if it did or not, but there was this image here that said Detective Mulligan, which obviously is reference to Toxin, or the gentleman who becomes Toxin. And we talked about that character recently in some of our episodes from the end of season 3, but his name is Patrick Mulligan, and he's a detective for, you know, the New York police in the comic books. And he ends up being the son of Carnage. Do I think Toxin's going to be in this movie? No, I don't think so, but it could, you know, Detective Mulligan be in this movie? Maybe. So I guess Tom Hardy posted that picture and deleted it, and I saw Tom Hardy Italia, which is an account we've been following since season 1 of this show, and we've looked to them for information at times too, even though, you know, they're not really a source, but they still do post stuff about, you know, Tom Hardy, because they clearly are in love with Tom Hardy, and that's understandable. So when I saw that account post it, and they said, oh, this was on Tom Hardy's page, I, you know, normally I catch, you know, what Tom Hardy posts. Sometimes I miss it, sure. But I try to, you know, keep an eye on my Instagram and stuff. If I go to work, you know, I try to, you know, check on my breaks and, you know, lunches and stuff to see if there's any information out there, so I know what videos to cover for you guys, especially around that time, because he seemed to be posting a lot and deleting it. But I didn't see anything. And most of the people who normally send me pictures saying, hey, Tom posted this and he deleted it, most of them didn't catch it either. So that's why I was kind of suspicious of this image. I mean, you know, who knows? It could be true. I just couldn't verify it anyway. And none of the normal people who are big fans of Venom who contact me, you know, and these, I'm not saying they're sources, but they'll, like, you know, they're just fans like I am. And they'll see this and they'll go, hey, Tom posted this, but he deleted it. Usually they'll catch it too. So the fact that my usual, you know, people and friends didn't catch it and I didn't catch it, I was kind of skeptical about it. But I thought, well, let's talk about it here. Let's bring that photo back since we never really covered it. We did talk about it on a live stream, though, I think. But let's just say this could be true. You know, this does feed into the SFPD stuff. So that's why I wanted to mention it in this video, because some people were speculating that Stephen Graham is actually going to play the character of, you know, of Patrick Mulligan. And I don't know if that's true either. I mean, I like Stephen Graham. He's awesome. Would it be cool to see him play a good guy and be a detective in this? Yeah, absolutely. But I know sometimes he, you know, will play bad guys or people with more morally gray areas. But then again, kind of Patrick Mulligan can be construed as that as well, and kind of be interpreted that way as well. So it'll be interesting. But what I like, though, is that the potential here, out of 13 cast members that are listed on the IMDb page for Venom 2, three of them are listed as, or well, two of them are listed as SFPD officers, but Sean Delaney, I went and checked out his account and saw him in the uniform, so I'm gonna guess he is too. So potentially 3 out of 13 cast members already are listed as SFPD, and that's that's interesting to me. I'm kind of like, all right, that's cool. You know, like that's that might mean the cops have a bigger role to play in this movie, which would make sense because Eddie Brock is probably gonna, you know, have to do research on Cletus Cassidy. He, you know, at the end of the first movie, he got that interview, and then, you know, he's like, yeah, there's more bodies. You know, the government just knows about this amount of bodies, but there's actually more bodies. And then we saw that journal that was shown off at New York Comic Con from Cletus Cassidy, and it listed in there, like, you know, they're never gonna find out what happened or whatever. So it looks like Eddie's here is gonna dig and learn more about Cletus Cassidy, learn about those bodies that weren't discovered and the murder that he's committed that he hasn't been pinned for yet. And so that could be the case, and that would involve him interacting with the police more. But it would also be interesting to see, you know, him build a relationship like a Commissioner Gordon type with someone like Patrick Mulligan or one of the SFPD people, just to build that, you know, supporting cast for Eddie Brock and Venom. It'd be neat to see him kind of, you know, team up or work with alongside somebody in that regard. You know, it could just help us, you know, help solidify his role in the city of San Francisco more, you know, because in the first movie, he just kind of shows up and does things, but he's, you know, he's not really a superhero, and people aren't really, like, fully aware of his existence. Although I'm sure now people might be, especially if he's just going into, like, corner stores and eating people, like, word's going to get around for sure. So I'm curious, and I want to know what you guys think about this, about the SFPD stuff. I'd love to hear your thoughts. We do have one more video I'm going to make right after this about other casting, about a potential party, and some of the theories we could have about that. So definitely tune in to that next episode, and that'll be going up probably tomorrow. Like, I'll post this one, you know, maybe I'll schedule it for Monday to go up when I'm having surgery, and then maybe I'll post the other one on Tuesday. So, you know, keep on lookout, make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss out, because we're going to talk about two actors that have been cast as potential party, you know, people in a party at, you know, in this movie, and what that could mean and what kind of party it could be. We're just going to speculate a lot and have some fun. So make sure you're back here in the next episode for that. But let me know your comments about all this. Do you think Stephen Graham might be playing Detective Mulligan? Do you think, you know, what do you think of, like, Sean Delaney, Alfred Tavares, Obi Matthew, all being SFPD officers, even though one's uncredited and one is not listed as an SFPD officer, but, you know, his Instagram shows that he could be. I'd love to hear your thoughts on all that. Do you want the police to have a bigger role? Do you not want them to have a bigger role? You know, I'd love to hear your thoughts. Let them all be known down below. And as always, we'll continue our conversation down there. Thanks so much for watching the show. As always, like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff. And I'll see you in the future. Peace.